Welcome back. So just last week, we told you about deep fakes, those realistic looking photos, videos, and audio recordings of people saying and doing things that they simply did not say or do.
Well, now there's AI generated text deep fakes.
Tech consultant and host of the podcast Think About This, Shelley Palmer, joining us now with much more on this. Shelley, good morning. Always great to see you.
Good morning. How are you guys doing?
How are you doing? So tell us about this, because obviously you've taught us to look at things with a critical eye. Neither of us had ever heard of text deepfake. So first and foremost, what is this?
So very often when you read something that's report-based, like you're reading sports scores in the newspaper or financial analysis where they're just listing the financial state of a company, that's already written by computer, in quotes. It's not AI, it's just a way for data to be presented in English. There's a new AI model at OpenAI called GPT-3. It's the third generation. You give this particular piece of AI an idea. You say to it something like, please list all of the countries in the world and their gross domestic product, and it will write it down for you. If you say, I'd like you to write Harry Potter stories in the style of Raymond Chandler, it doesn't matter, name something, it's going to happen. And what's remarkable about GPT-3, more than any other product I've ever seen in the world of AI, more than any other program, is that you need to give it almost no information. It's so powerful, it literally can write computer code. You could say something like, please make me a button shaped like a watermelon. Please make me a button that says buy now. And it will just write you the code. If you tell it what you want the code written in, please write it in React, please write it in JavaScript. It will just know how to do that. It's really one of the most powerful things I've ever seen. And so the first thing someone did with it after the little demos was someone started to write tweets in very misogynistic or very anti-Semitic or very heavily racially biased ways, because as good as it is as writing in styles, it can write tweets as fast as you can think about it. And someone started filling in a tweet bot army filled with this kind of nonsense, and written so incredibly well, to call it what I have to call it, the computers that generally look for that kind of stuff thought they were people, not computers. So it's not really deep faked, it's AI created, because it's not faked for a name. Some of these troll bot armies are all fake, but you can usually tell it's a bot because it's written very mechanically. Here, this tool set's able to write prolifically like a person, or like a lot of people, or like people that don't exist. It's spectacular in its capability and scary and frightening in what it may turn out to be.
Now, Shelley, are you afraid at all that this may pose some dangers to human creativity in terms of authors and writers?
Yeah, I don't know that I'm concerned about creativity. I'm concerned about the volume and veracity of what's written. I think it's a beautiful assistive technology. If you're starting to write a lot of advertising copy and you need to write all kinds of things that have to be search engine optimized, of course, it's a wonderful tool. But if you just let it go, you're not going to be able to tell if it's written by a person or a machine. And that's interesting by itself. People always say, oh, computers will never, ever pass the Turing test. This idea of, I know it's not a computer because I'm a human and I ask it enough questions. Remember, AI doesn't have to pass a Turing test. Human beings have to fail it. And I think this is the first technology I've ever seen where you'd be hard-pressed to know that what you're looking at was written by a computer. Hard-pressed.
Shelley Palmer, thanks so much for that. We appreciate it.